हेलो वैदिक विजन फॉलोवर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स, ऑल द ग्रुप मेंबर्स, अ वार्म वेलकम टू यू. थैंक यू फॉर वाचिंग आवर वीडियोस एंड गिविंग अस सो मेनी ब्यूटीफुल कमेंट्स. थैंक यू वेरी मच. टुडे वी हैव अ न्यू गेस्ट ऑन आवर चैनल, सुनीली मैम, सुनीली जानी पवार, वेलकम.
नमस्ते।
I don't think we need to introduce her. She is a well-known face in our astrological world. She has her own channel with the name of Planet to Soul, and she is into teaching, consultations, and so many connected to astrology from so many years. Ma'am, it is a great honor to host you today. I think people know you from all fields of life, in astrology especially. And you have a channel. I'll give the channel link below in my description section. Please go and visit her channel. Ma'am is into teaching and also consultations. She holds many webinars, etc. Ma'am, what are we going to do today?
Yeah, thank you, Shikha, and thank you very much to all your viewers also who will be watching this video as well. See, we all are in Jyotish Shastra and different streams of Jyotish, but the ultimate goal is to just dig out the pearls out of this Jyotish Shastra in the form of techniques, methods, whatever we can understand. These are the rules. We name it as a snapshot, or we name it as a techniques, or we name it as a methods. But when we are talking about particular subject, and on your channel, when I'm going to talk, that is about Ketu. What I have observed till now through my experiences and through the books which I have referred so many books together, and then I come to a conclusion that yes, this Ketu thing is really working. Because this nodes, Rahu and Ketu, they are aprakashit planets. They do not have their own lives. That is why they call it the shadow planets. And this Rahu Ketu are very much connected to our material life, because we are connected to material life, we are in human life. Otherwise, we could have gone to some different yoni, because that different yoni other than human is they cannot speak, they cannot understand, they cannot do anything. They are paravalambi. They are not that much independent. They live in jungles, or they live in humans' life, like our pets, what we keep in our houses or something, or kitak yoni. But when we talk about Ketu, so all these things together is combined with Ketu, because we connect Ketu to all these yonis. We cannot combine Ketu, or we cannot bind Ketu in only one yoni. Like, this is only my thing or human only. That is why we connect Ketu to spirituality also. Why? Because spiritual level is equal to everyone. That is why we say that go seva, or giving services to any shelter homes, or pets also, and animal shelter homes also. We connect the remedies to this Ketu. So when we talk about Ketu, the first thing comes in our mind that this is a liberation, or this is moksha karak Ketu. But moksha from where? You do not know that what is the actual meaning of moksha. Moksha doesn't mean that you are sitting hours together and meditating, and then you are feeling that now I am in a moksha. No. Unless and until you get satisfaction out of that meditation, that satisfaction, that saturation point is called as a moksha. Moksha we never attain after death. Moksha is attained every day, each moment of our life. When you prepare very good food for your family, and when you get satisfied, that is a level of moksha for you. You got your fruits immediately. When you are being appreciated, you are being honored at certain situation, you are on a mode of moksha. That means you are alipta from, you are away from that situation. You have gained your appreciation, or whatever creditability you are getting. So that Ketu starts activating over there in you. Once you get many chocolates to eat, and one fine day you doesn't like chocolate, that means you are over with those chocolates.
Right.
You are moksha because you are satisfied with that situation. So first, this basic fundamental thing everyone has to understand, that moksha is not only after spiritual activities or spiritual lessons, but moksha is through your daily life. That is why we are born with Rahu Ketu alignment here, opposite to each other. Why they are opposite to each other? Only Rahu Ketu are such a shadow planet which are opposite to each other. Not other planet will come opposite to each other except Rahu and Ketu, 180 degrees, because that is one body. All
yes.
other planets have an individual body.
Body.
Only this is a planet which has two bodies, two in one. That is why we always consider that many things together when we do, when we go in a gatherings also, the Rahu gets activated too much. And when you are away from that gatherings, you are activating Ketu in you because your habit is of that Ketu. And when I saw in many charts, that how this Ketu, what this Ketu is asking me in my this life. You know, we always connect past life, we always connect prarabdha, we always connect what I have to dig down in this life or how I have to perform my life lessons in this life cycle, astrologically as well as materially also, because we all have different life than astrology. We are living different life. In astrology, we are different. And
right.
in personal life, we are different. That is also Ketu. That is why Ketu is called as Bahurupiya. Rahu
yeah.
is called as Bahurupiya.
Okay.
That is why we are humans on this earth. So what I have seen, Shikha, that wherever your Ketu is posited in a chart, the fourth house from your Ketu, because fourth house is basically your Sukhasthana.
Right.
That is your comfort zone.
Mm-hmm.
Where you get comfort after hours of work and then you go to sleep. When you were small, you were sleeping on your mother's lap. That is why we connect mother to fourth house of chart. And then we become relaxed. We do not have any fear in our mind once our mind is settled. And that is why we always see that when my house will happen, I am living in a rented house or I am not getting peace of mind in my house or I'm not getting proper sleep, and everything depends on fourth house of our chart. But you know, this Ketu, what I have observed through many charts, that whenever you see fourth house from your Ketu, that house gets activated to snatch something from you related to that house, right? And exactly opposite to that house is something you have to pay off. I'll give you a simple example. If you have Ketu in your eighth house of chart, right? So definitely it will be from your eighth house, the fourth house happens to be 11th house, right? So 11th house is connected to your friend circle,
correct?
Your gains,
right?
Right? Or whatever things are connected to signification of that 11th house, you are lacking in those houses in spite of hard work also, in spite of giving your best. If you have many people around you, but you do not have very close friends, you are away from them. That is 11th house, where Ketu is exactly giving fruits of that fourth house from its own position.
Okay.
And maybe you are not able to keep good connectivity with your friend circle. And exactly opposite to that 11th house falls as a fifth house of your chart.
Okay.
That fifth house that your children are asking karmas from you. Even if they are not doing anything or they are doing anything at any age, you have to do always for them.
Yeah, you have to take
they
care
are,
of them always.
They are asking only. You have to give out.
Achha. So this is something
is
new
some,
for me.
Ketu, you see, Ketu is a karmic connectivity. Ketu is jitna aap de doge, utna aapka jhuli bliss se bhar jayega. It is something like that.
Achha.
So, wherever this fourth house from Ketu and exactly opposite to that house, this is a different triangle, you know. This is the different triangle. This is 180 degree where Ketu is exactly affecting your chart. There are many other techniques also to see Ketu, spirituality, all these things. But when you know that what karmas I have to pay off, why I am doing this in my life, why always in spite of doing so much for my studies also, always, fifth house is connected to your study also, still you will go on spending for that, still constantly you are working on that zone only. You are trying to improvise yourself. That is what this Ketu is asking from you. And once you are fulfilled with that, once you get satisfied, then you can say that my ninth house will now get activated. Then you can say that ninth house is your agami karmas, where the accumulation of your deeds, whatever you are doing in this life, they are also gathering in your ninth house of chart.
So once you do the fulfillment of the 11th house, like whatever example we have taken now, Ketu in the 8th house, fulfillment of the 11th house, like once we give more and more to the 11th house, all those karmas and everything deeds get collected in the 9th house. Do you mean to say that?
Yeah, somewhat. But we have to see that 11th house karmas are pending for us. That is why we are not getting fruits of that house.
Yes, of course.
Like 11th house is of your friend circle. It's a simple example.
Correct.
But you are not very connected to your friends. So what one should do, they have to make at least cordial relationship with those friends.
We have to put in efforts. Put in efforts.
Efforts.
Yeah.
Right? But right, exactly opposite to 11th house, 5th house, without putting efforts, you have to do compulsory.
Understood.
When you are in an exact position of that, giving and taking and again giving, then 9th house gets activated. That is your bhagya, that is your spirituality, that is your dharma. Then your Ketu dharma is fulfilled.
Okay. So, I have a question, like, how different is this from wherever Ketu is placed? Like, generally, the principle you have told, fourth from Ketu, the same principle we follow wherever Rahu, Ketu are actually placed. We say wherever Ketu is placed, we have virakta, means we have a disattachment from that house and all the karakatvas of that house. And now you are taking fourth into consideration, right? So, how do we differ from where actually Ketu is sitting and fourth from Ketu? What is the difference between these two?
Wherever this Ketu is posited, definitely you have a lingering desires of that particular house.
Desires?
That is why, yes, that is not getting fulfilled. You are digging more and more. Again, I will take example of 8th house.
Correct.
You are buckled, you still feel that I am not fulfilled with this.
You are not satisfied with whatever you are doing. Correct.
Whatever you do, you are not satisfied with whatever you do. And Ketu gives you virakti.
Yeah, virakti.
Then you give up the situation also. You give up the whole thing you have started, and then in between only you feel like giving up. And then again the same chakra starts. Again that Ketu, that is stale. It is always in a motion. Again that thing comes in your mind. No, again I will do this. This is Ketu. Stopping and doing. Stopping and doing. So wherever your Ketu is posited, definitely you are lacking signification connected to that house. If you will say your Ketu is posited in 9th house of chart, so definitely you are away from your father, or you are lacking in your father's bliss. You are lacking in your dharma. Even though you are spiritual by nature, it is not necessary that every time you are going to temple and you are doing offerings. Maybe these people do not go to temples also.
Correct.
But people say 9th house Ketu is very good. No, that is very good for your agami things.
Yes.
Which is going to happen when Ketu Dasha will start, that time this Ketu will get activated.
Correct.
And then which planet this Ketu is posited, which planet this Ketu is aspecting, that also plays very, very important role. You have to you have to work more on that particular house where Ketu is posited, because always you are thinking about that. Why I did not get this? And ultimately giving you virakti, that is detachment.
So, don't we have this, like I have seen in many charts, wherever Ketu is placed, they already have this detachment. They are not concerned with that house. So, you are saying once we go through the process, we have the detachment and then again we start that same process.
Yes.
That's what you feel, that is what is you have come across.
Yes, because see, it is detachment doesn't mean that you are not living in that situation. When you will say it is detached, when you are no more in that situation.
Achha.
But when compulsorily you have to be in that situation, that means that Ketu is again and again forcing you to be in that situation. You cannot leave that situation. Aap ghar chhodke nahi ja sakte, even though if you do not, you want to go and stay into an ashram, you cannot go there, because fourth house Ketu, if you will feel that I am away from my home, maybe I'm changing many houses, because Ketu will never keep you steady
in
at one
house.
Place. But still you have to do that.
Yeah.
That is what Ketu asking.
Correct.
So again and again performing the same things, that is what Ketu is asking. And same thing when you see in your D9 chart also, in Vedic Jyotish, I do follow divisional charts. I give much importance to that also. So this Ketu, whenever you come across in D9 chart and wherever this Ketu is posited, definitely that house also needs rectification. How we do birth rectification, wherever your Ketu goes in Navamansh Kundali, that house related rectification is must needed, and the opposite house to that. Seven.
Okay.
So if it is going in first house of chart, so first house is you yourself. You have to improve. You are lacking or you are behind in your life because of your own attitude, because of your own nature. You have to accept it that somewhere I am wrong. People are not wrong.
Yeah.
So you have to judge yourself and then work on that thing. And exactly opposite to your first house is your seventh house. That is your spouse as well as your public image will be totally dependent on that.
All right.
You have to give off to your spouse because you are feeling detached from that spouse. But still you have to do for that spouse. Because of your past karma, that is why you have got this position in your chart.
Correct.
And then you see which sign it is going. Then definitely we have to see particularly, as I told about 4,000. Again, you have to, if you want to go for more research or more predictions, you have to see that which house is fourth to your Ketu or which sign is posited fourth to your Ketu. Whether there are any planets posited fourth to Ketu, then that planets also get affected.
Correct.
Because there is a 4-10 connectivity then.
Right.
If you will see from 4th to Ketu, from that house, Ketu goes into 10th house. That is detachment, ultimately. When you see Ketu, you will say that you will not be attached to these things, right? So 4-10 we can consider as our karmic cycle, not only profession and work. So from that house, you have to consider that 4 and 10 situation will be always there.
Always there. Concerning that house, particular house and rashi.
Yes, that will be always there. So this is something always we say that Rahu Ketu, people talk so much about Rahu Ketu, even still we feel that nothing is fulfilled. You know, we are not getting proper, theories about Rahu Ketu, because people say that Rahu Ketu has aspect also. I do not consider aspect of Rahu Ketu.
Acha, both the planets you don't consider.
No, I don't consider. I only consider they are opposite to each other. They are one body. So they have connectivity with these two houses only.
Okay.
Wherever they are there. But in past life connectivity, if you will see, then definitely where the reflection of that shadow planet comes.
Achha.
The
so,
reflection.
What
if
is
the camera? The reflection is in the form of photograph.
Correct.
Right? you get a photograph in
Correct.
reflection, but
Correct.
you are in darkness whenever you are taking out that photo.
Correct.
And then the reflection comes. Same way, what I said about fourth house that reflects in your opposite house to that house.
Okay. So that is the 10th from Ketu. Fourth and opposite to it. 10th from Ketu.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. If your Ketu is posited in fifth house of chart.
Correct.
Right? Then your eighth house comes as a fourth house.
And the second house comes as a reflection of that.
No. Then, yes, second house comes as a reflection. Yes, absolutely right.
Correct.
Then you have to give too much to your second house. Your family needs you more.
Yes, yes. Got it. That is a wonderful rule. People go and check it out. Like, I think I have never heard about fourth from Ketu, actually. Of course, Ketu is multiplicity, that we always know. Wherever Ketu is placed, that things you have to do again and again. And mostly, like, there was a class which I had attended, and there were so many astrologers over there. And surprisingly, all of them had Rahu in the 4th house and Ketu in the 10th house. And see, everyone said, we have changed our profession so many number of times.
Yes, yes.
Multiplicity Ketu always gives more than one, wherever it is placed. This was just an example. Very beautiful concept, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. This is like, you know, this is not only for Ketu. You can see each planet, fifth house, first house, second house, third house, fourth house. Likewise, you have to consider all.
Oh yeah, whatever they are giving, right?
Yes.
A wonderful
yes.
technique. People, please go and check it out, and we'll see you very soon. Thank you very much.
Dhanyavaad.